To win a fight, you not only have to be tough, but you also have to be strong-minded. Because if one day you find yourself facing an unequal confrontation, only your intelligence can save you from a fatal outcome. So, if you think that height and weight are systematically determining factors in boxing, MMA, kickboxing, or Greco-Roman wrestling match, today you'll be very surprised. Settle down well. You will see the spectacular images of the most unequal sport fights. Here are the 10 most unequal fights in history. Among the uneven sporting fights are that between Croatian Mirko Filipovic, nicknamed Krokop, and South Korea's Hongman Choi. To give you an idea of the disparity of statures, the Croatian is 1m88 tall and weighs 106 kg. The South Korean is 2m19 tall and weighs 160 kg. Filipovic had a modest start. He trained in a garage with few means and few tools. He trained alone in the practice of mixed martial arts, following the example of references such as Bruce Lee and Jean-Claude Van Damme. During the K1 Premium Dynamite in 2008, the Croatian and the South Korean are in confrontation. Their difference in size is obvious. When the fight begins, they gauge each other, and for a few minutes, Choi seems to be more offensive while his opponent withdraws most often. But the South Korean was soon thrown off balance after being kicked in his private parts, which were protected by a shell. He got up and seconds later he was knocked out with a knee kick. The blow was critical. The giant collapsed, and the Croatian was declared the winner. In his day, the great Kali was a wrestling monument, a formidable wrestler and fighter who intimidated the fiercest opponents. He was predisposed to develop extraordinary muscular strength, as he was afflicted with acromegaly, a hormonal abnormality that causes hypertrophy of the face, hands, and feet. Measuring 2m16 and weighing 158 kg, he is simply overpowering and his career is full of victories. So, when he faces Oscar Gutierrez Rubio, who is barely 1m68 tall and weighs 79 kg, we unfortunately already know the outcome. And the great Kali confirms, with him, there will be no miracle. The gap is really too big. Poor Rubio is beaten flatly by his titanic rival, with a catch movement called the choke slam. The great Kali grabs his poor victim by the neck, holds her suspended high, and propels her violently to the ground. No chance left to the Mexican. It's a clean demolition. Let's move on to kickboxing. It's 2011. It's a tournament in Hungary, during which the Hungarian Tivadar Kunli faces a real mastodon, Bob Sapp, an American kickboxer, nicknamed the Beast, who is almost 1m90 tall and weighs 150 kg. The duel promises to be very unequal. Indeed, the American is twice the weight of his opponent and the difference in size is striking. It wouldn't be surprising if Sapp was just one bite out of the Hungarian. But as proof that muscular power does not always win, the first moments of the fight suggest that the rest will be more balanced than expected. Tivadar doesn't intend to let this happen, and to everyone's surprise, he kicks the Beast to the ground with a kick to the chest. He is stunned and gets up with difficulty. After this tour de force, the Hungarian redoubled his confidence and once again overcame the giant with a very effective sweeping kick. The American retaliates energetically, but the Hungarian also galvanized, punches his rival in the head, and throws him to the ground. Tivadar thwarts all expectations and signs a victory that proves that there is never a victory before the fight. Here is without a doubt a boxing match that every boxing fan knows, the incredible defeat of heavyweight champion Mike Tyson against Buster Douglas, an underdog on whom no one was counting. This event, which took place in Tokyo in 1990, has had a major impact on the history of the sport. The fight was so uneven that everyone thought it was a warm-up for Mike Tyson, who was known as the strongest boxer in the world. Sports analysts and consultants were not giving Buster Douglas a lot of money, and predicted an annihilation in 90 seconds. They even found it more interesting to talk about the pets of the two opponents, rather than the fight itself. Yet in the 10th round, Buster's upward punches defeated Tyson, who was already weakened by earlier blows. Mike Tyson was knocked down for the first time in his career and was unable to get up. Alexander Karlin is nicknamed the Russian Bear. He was the ace of Greco-Roman wrestling and was unbeatable from 1982 to 1987. He was so dominant in the fights that none of his opponents ever managed to get a single point out of him, and by all accounts, he is the greatest wrestler in history. He weighed 130 kilograms and was 6 feet tall. He won 24 gold medals and was 13 times Russian champion. It is said that his opponents lost psychologically to him even before facing him. Alexander Karelin even went so far as to say, "I have to be honest, I see the fear in the eyes of my opponents." Thus, in Sydney, Australia, Alexander Carlin faces his counterpart Rulin Gardner, who weighs 120 kilograms and is 1.87 meters tall, in a very unequal fight. Rulin Gardner is a simple farmer, and his only training consists of wrestling with cows. Needless to say, these original exercises regularly generated hilarity and controversy. But Carlin is a bear, not a cow. Gardner, the underdog, played defensively and preferred to leave the offensive initiatives to his opponent. The more the fight progressed, the more Carlin got tired. On the contrary, Gardner didn't flinch and defended very well. Defeated by attrition, the Russian bear abdicated. Nobody believed his eyes. A farmer defeated a great champion. Ikuhisa Manoa is a Japanese wrestler who is very popular in his country. He is 1.75 meters tall and weighs 83 kilograms. This Japanese wrestler has acquired a particularly flattering reputation. Having participated several times in openweight wrestling competitions, that is to say, competitions where all weight categories can compete against each other, he has often triumphed over opponents bigger than him. In fact, he has been nicknamed the Giant Killer. In a tough fight, Ikuhisa Manoa had to face a muscle monster weighing 185 kilograms, the Brazilian wrestler Zuluzino. The difference is spectacular. But throughout the fight, no miracles happen. The Brazilian inflicted a beating on the Japanese, slammed him to the ground, and punched him several times in the face and back of the head. This predictable defeat did not prevent the Japanese from being highly appreciated in his country. This time it was a duel between Japanese Genki Sudo and American ogre Eric Esch. The latter is so obese that he has been given the nickname, Butterbean. He weighs 205 kilograms, and his opponent of the day is almost a third of his weight. But even though Genki Sudo weighs only 70 kilos, he is more than a wrestler. He is a character. He is known for his charismatic style and technical prowess in combat. But does he stand a chance against an opponent who is far too strong for him on the surface? In any case, in the first moments of the fight, you can see right away that he has much more presence, liveliness, and speed. The duel turns rather quickly to the advantage of the Japanese, who, with a very skillful tour de force, puts Butterbean on the ground. Sudo grabs Eric Esch's leg and makes him suddenly lose his balance. He must certainly make the ground shake when he falls. Thanks to a very efficient grappling, the Japanese man immobilizes the American giant. Dominated and stifled, the American can't even give power to his punches. Thus, the Japanese triumphs hands down and proves once again that size doesn't matter in a fight. Here's another fight so unequal that it's hilarious. The kickboxer Daiju Takase weighs 83 kilograms, and in this duel, he faces an elephant, a mountain of flesh, Emmanuel Yarborough, who weighs more than 272 kilograms. And he has reached 363 kilograms. That's more than four times the weight of his opponent. Besides, Yarborough has done sumo, MMA, and American football. In this disproportionate fight between Yarborough and Takase, the weight difference is so great that it is not surprising that Yarborough is at a disadvantage. He is very slow and too heavy, and the little Japanese boy does not hesitate to take advantage of this. After 3 minutes, Takase grabbed his opponent's foot and tried to knock him down, but the giant eventually fell back on him and neutralized his legs. The Japanese had no choice but to escape the embrace and punch Yarborough in the head. Finally, he manages to extricate himself, he stands up, he wins the game. After several blows to the Indo-American's face, certainly, he must not have forgotten this victory against a man four times his size. When it comes to unequal confrontation, this is the ultimate. A sumo wrestler weighing in at 100 pounds against two young sumo wrestler apprentices as thin as rake. As you can imagine, there is nothing serious about this sumo wrestling match. This hilarious opposition is actually meant to entertain the children and the audience. You probably know the rules of this very popular Japanese sport. They are very simple. The wrestlers compete against each other and to win, each must push the other out of the circle where the wrestling takes place, or make the opponent touch the ground other than by the soles of his feet. The two children, seemingly more amused than motivated, approach the giant, make the usual greetings, and take turns trying to push him around. To say the least, their efforts do not pay off. Even as a joke, the sumo wrestler has no intention of giving in. The children alternate to move him with all their might by a few centimeters. As they struggle to push that mountain, the sumo wrestler ejects them in seconds, just by touching them. The children could have been even more numerous, they wouldn't have had a chance. No wonder, since this sumo wrestler must weigh four times the weight of these two children combined. That's the end of that video. In all these most unequal fights in history, which one surprised you the most?